Hi, I am Mahesh Mohata from Tucana Lights Private Limited. Tucana is a unique light design, engineering and manufacturing company. All our products are unique, they are patented, and today I am going to demonstrate one of our highest power lighting system. These lighting systems are bay lights, industrial bay lights. They are used in large factories, atriums, clubhouses, all kind of places, where the ceiling is very high, 20 feet to 50 feet, those kind of places, these bay lights are used. Our family of bay lights, we call them HT. These are heat tube based bay lights, and we have three models in this, and then there are numerous variants. So the highest power light is HT200, as you can see, it has a 60 degree beam angle. Then we have HT135 with 60 degree beam angle, and then we have HT135 which has 90 degree beam angle. So depending upon the lux levels and intensity you need at the floor, various lights can be used. We do dialog simulation to give you a proper estimation of these lights. Now these lights are very unique. These are called HT lights because they are heat tube based lights. These are unique light to the world. These are the only heat tube based lights which are available in India, and probably nowhere you'll find heat tube lights which are made like this, So now I'm going to explain it to you why we need heat tubes. What difference do heat tubes make, and what is the heat tube technology? Before I get into that, let me try to explain you what happens in an LED light, high power, especially the high power LED lights. There is a general belief that LED lights do not produce heat, but that's not exactly the fact. In fact, the moment LED light systems become high on wattage, the heat becomes the biggest challenge to beat. Let me show you one LED chip mounted printed circuit board. And this circuit board, as you can see, is mounted with numerous LED chips. These are the small LED chips, solid state elements which generate heat. When direct current, which is coming through this cable, when direct current is applied to these chips, the heat chips glow from one side, and from the other side they dissipate heat. Now the heat dissipation can be almost 60% to 70% of all power supplied to this chip system. Now 60 to 70% if that is what we are talking about, then that means a light like this, which is 200 watt lighting, almost 120 watt to 140 watt of all power which goes into this light is converted into heat. Now this heat has to be managed because the LED chips are very heat sensitive. These are electronic devices. This heat sensitivity erode the life of the LED chips. The LED chips performance falls down, and that is the biggest cause why LED chips may start producing less light as the time goes by. For all lighting designers across the world, the challenge is how to provide best heat sinking solution. Heat sinking solution essentially means how to export heat out of the system so that the LED chips do not get damaged by the heat which they themselves produce. So we found out one of the best technology which can be used to export heat. Now this technology is a rocket science actually. It is called heat tube technology. Heat tube technology was invented and started getting used in 1960s when rockets were being tested. Rockets also generate a lot of heat, and that heat would burn the rocket. So heat tubes were used to export the heat away from the rockets to a far off place. Now, what is the benefit of this heat tube technology? It is that it can conduct heat up to 200 times more than that of solid copper. Now that is a very high level of conductivity. So let me try to explain how do the heat tubes work. So this is a heat tube which is installed here. To begin with, it is a hollow extrusion made of aluminium. This is aircraft grade aluminium, which is made to our specifications, to our design. It's hollow to begin with, but then there's a proprietary procedure by which within each tube a partial vacuum is created and there's an evaporative fluid. Now the heat tube's principle is like this: when the evaporative fluid receives heat, it evaporates at a much lower temperature because there is a partial vacuum. It's so, as per Charles' law, as the vapor pressure reduces, the fluid boils at lower temperature. Now the vapors have the capacity to export heat at the fastest possible level. You know, the conductivity, as I said, can be up to 200 times of copper. So the same kind of mechanism we have encapsulated in our heat tubes. Now a light like this has 6 heat tubes. The job of these 6 heat tubes is to immediately pick up the heat from the LED chips and take it away to this zone. Now this is the zone where the heat is captured and heat is dissipated by these various fins. These fins enhance the surface area of the heated part, and that improves the performance. Aluminium is the material of choice for making any lighting. We use purest form of aluminium for the lighting, which has very high quality of surface finish, which can be anodized. This anodized finish stays forever. It shines like unbelievable. Aluminium is second or third most reflective material in the world. Almost 90% plus of light which falls on aluminium is reflected back. The reflector inside, that also reflects light along with the lenses. But more important than that is that the aluminium, with its high thermal conductivity, and from end to end, the entire light works as a heat sink. So the entire light is a heat dissipating device. See, I have dismantled one light to show you what the entire heat sinking all about. Now in this light you can see there are heat tubes which are taking away heat from the bottom and they dissipate heat. One important factor about dissipating heat is ventilation. If there are hot air pockets, then heat will not dissipate. This lighting has 360 degree air ventilation, as you can see, and there's a lot of space. There's almost 30 mm space between the two heat tubes. So now this distance, this space between the heat tubes, ensures that there's a cross ventilation of air. Heat does not stay accumulated. There are no hot air pockets. You know, one of the important features of this light is that the driver, which convert alternate current into direct current, which drive the LED lights, they are placed far above the LED chips. There is a distance of about 250 mm. So the heat which is generated by LEDs, that's not transmitted to the driver. Drivers are themselves very heat sensitive, and one of the biggest cause of a industrial light failing is the failure of the driver, and it's quite a headache to change it replace it, etc. So you know, the kind of precautions we have taken is, one is this distance of 250 mm, and secondly the way the drivers are housed inside the light. So you can see, let me show you what's happening. These are the electronic drivers which control the incoming alternate current into direct current, and in very precise amperage. Now this current, while goes through the LED, the drivers themselves produce heat, and that heat damages the driver. So drivers have to be protected from the heat they produce and what heat LEDs produce. Now you see, to make the drivers cool, what we do is, the innovation which we have done here is, The drivers are encased in aluminium housing and the drivers are potted. Potting compound is a thermally conductive polyurethane which takes away the heat from hot components of the driver and passes it to the surface of the driver box. You see, the surface of driver box is again another pure aluminium component. So the heat which is generated inside is dissipated all through the surface of the driver box. Now that makes the drivers cooler. One, their own heat is dissipated. Secondly, they do not get heat from the LED chips, which is the biggest source of heat because of the distance. Let me also share with you what is special that we do with LED chips and the printed circuit board. First, on the LED chips. Our LED chips are from the best company in the world, like Osram from Germany, Bezlux from USA, Seoul Optics from Korea, Cree from USA, or Nichia, Japan. Now, these LEDs are thoroughly tested by these companies and they are found to be the best LEDs, which have tremendous resistivity against failure. They have high quality assurance programs and these are the best LEDs, LED chips which one can find anywhere in the world. Then we have done yet another safety feature for the light. You see, this printed circuit board is for 135 watt LED lighting. Now each chip can carry 1 watt. So, you know, if there were 135 chips, the printed circuit board would have been okay. But we have provided double the number of chips. Now, while you know, the number of chips doubles up, but the amount of current which goes through each chip is less than half of what its capacity is. Now, that also means that each chip gets less heated and that enhances the life of the LED chip that produces unbelievable longevity for the LED chip board. All our high power lights come with optics. Now this the printed circuit board has an optic on the top. These are small lenses which ensure that the light coming out of the LED chip goes to the area where the functionality at the factory or workplace is happening. LED lights usually give out beam angle of 120 degree and if the 120 degree beam angle is kept at a very high ceiling, then the light would be spread at the top and not enough would come at the floor level where the work is actually happening. So the 60 degree, as is the case in this particular lens, this ensures that the light intensity on the floor is 4 times more than what if it would have been a 120 degree beam angle. So, you know, so this lens is mounted on the top and you can see the LEDs behind and the lens comes on the top like this. So there are lenses at first level to direct light to the workplace. And apart from that, the aluminium reflector, which reflects up to 90% of light, works as secondary optics. So this technique is called hybrid optics. Very few people use it now because the aluminium reflector costs money and our aluminium reflector is a thick 2.2 mm aluminium sheet. It is hand spun and this aluminium reflector also works as primary heat sink. Now this element, reflector cum heat sink, is also a patented technology by Tucana Lights. So as you can see here, the magic of hybrid light reflection technology. The light which goes astray after passing through the lens is redirected by the reflector. This also ensures that the light falling on the floor does not have a torch effect. In fact, it has a diffused border which is pleasing for work and it is pleasing to mix light from different units of light hanging on the ceiling. So let me finally explain to you what we have tried to do with this light. We have tried to make a light which does not fail, which does not age, and we have used the most premium components and a very innovative design with best heat tube technology here. So amongst the components, you know, there is no compromise. All the elements here, like a eye hook, nut and bolts, screws, everything is stainless steel 304, so it does not rust. There's a specially designed cable gland which is in brass. There are other elements which are in aluminium, which are anodized, so they never go bad. They're in normal working condition, this shine is expected to last for almost ever, as long as they're not exposed. The drivers inside this driver box are from the best company in the country. They are from Pyrotech, and they are also from a German company called BAG that depends on the lighting system. So some of them have BAG drivers, which is part of Osram, and some of these lights have Pyrotech drivers, which is another leading company from the country. The chips are from Osram and Bridgelux, those kind of international brands. So Tucana has taken fullest care to make light which is premium, which has longevity, perfect functionality and a beauty. A mix of these four things would be very rare to find in the industry. The industry has moved to cast aluminium bodies because they are cheaper, easy to make, and they can be mass produced, those kind of things. Now, cast aluminium, as everybody knows, has 13% silicone, has poor conductivity, can have a lot of weight, but because the fin size is thick, it does not conduct so much of heat. And regarding beauty, I think nobody would call cast aluminium light as beautiful. While we have tried to give sculptured lights, we will move on to this philosophy. This has the best of everything, best of light, heat dissipation abilities, best of the optics, best of the material, and best of the drivers. And yet, these lights are not as expensive as one might imagine. They may be available for the cost of just a little more than the cast aluminium lights. And if you want to choose lights which, apart from functionality, have beauty and longevity, please look no further. Tucana is the right product for you. Here I must tell you that all Tucana products are designed, engineered and made in India. There are very few products which fall in these three categories and are patented for 20 years. Okay, so I want to thank you for listening to this presentation and hope you would take pride in a Tucana product the way we take. Thank you so much. Bye-bye.